Following Japan's declaration of war on the United States, Hawaii has been under two air attacks today. More than 10 persons were wounded when enemy planes machine gunned a town near Honolulu, according to a Reuters dispatch. And General Douglas MacArthur has ordered all women and children in Manila to evacuate the seacoast and move to areas inland. The Dutch East Indies has just declared war on Japan, and Costa Rica in South America has also declared war. Keep tuned to this station for further developments.
Inner Sanctum Mystery, brought to you by the makers of Carter's Little Liver Pills, the best friend to your sunny disposition.
Good evening, friends. This is Raymond, your host, welcoming you again to the Inner Sanctum. Come in, won't you? Why am I smiling? Oh, but I always smile when I open the creaking door on Sunday night. You see, each week when I say good evening, I think to myself, a good evening for what? And of course, there's only one answer to that question. A good evening for a murder.
Tonight, Inner Sanctum Mysteries brings you The Island of Death, an original radio mystery drama written by Robert Newman and presented for your entertainment by the makers of Carter's Little Liver Pill. Friends, a pleasant disposition shouldn't be just a once-in-a-while affair. It ought to be a regular thing. See if you can't make it regular by encouraging regularity with Carter's Little Liver Pill. Let them wake up the flow of one of your most vital digestive juices and prove to yourself that Carter's Little Liver Pills are the best friend to your sunny disposition.
Now I think we're ready to begin. Ready to begin as strange and terrible a tale as ever turned a man's hair gray overnight. A tale of voodoo, conjuring, black magic. Oh, now you're smiling. You don't believe in voodoo, huh? Good. Now turn down the lights, pull your chair up close, and listen to the story of the Island of Death. Come with me to the Dark Island, the secret magic island, Tahiti. It is night. A fierce tropical storm is raging. A car drives slowly down the road with a cane field on one side of it, a jungle on the other.
Now which way?
I don't know, Jim.
Last, Brandon. Why did he let us go off alone? How are we going to get back there?
But he told us not to go off alone, John. John, look.
Where?
Ahead there. That old native walking up the road. Maybe he can...
Yeah. Hey! Hey, you! Hey! What's the matter with him? Is he deaf? Now you keep blowing the horn while I put my coat on and go after Muriel.
All right, John. Well, there's something wrong with it.
Hey?
It doesn't work.
Well, it was working just a minute ago. Now, what in the name of...
Something, monsieur.
Oh, so you did hear me. Why didn't you come when I called you?
I am not in the habit of coming when I am called that way, monsieur. Besides, though I am an old man, my ears are very sensitive. The noise of your horn pained me. That's why I stopped it.
You stopped it? Why, you? Well, okay. We're looking for the plantation St. Jack. Are we on the right road?
You are on the right road for many things, monsieur.
Right? How did you know my name?
It was told me.
Oh. Well, how do we get there?
If you go down this road 1 mile, you'll see it on your right. And when you get there, well, perhaps we will meet again.
If we do, I'll... Hey, where did he go to?
Oh, I don't know. He just disappeared.
Step back off the road into the jungle. Well... At least we know where we are now.
Yes. John.
Hey.
Do you suppose he was a papaloi, a witch doctor?
What on earth makes you think that?
I don't know. The way he looked and talked. And after all, the horn did stop working.
Oh, coat?
No, Allenby.
Gloria.
All right. I'll hang up his coat.
Allenby, you have to make things even more difficult than they are already.
Would it make things any easier if I pretended that we were just old friends? It didn't matter to me that you'd married him instead of me.
No, Allen, I guess not.
I'm sorry, Muriel. I didn't.
Hello, Allen. Order me a drink, will you?
Of course. Yeah, I'll drink to Mr. Coates.
Yes, Monsieur Randall. I was.
Did you find out what was wrong with the horn?
Yeah, one of the wires had come loose. Met an old native on the road, and Muriel's convinced that he was a witch doctor.
But it's just that he was so strange, and, well, even though I know that there are no such things...
What we know or believe isn't terribly important. What is important is what the natives believe. They don't like being laughed at.
You mean they really still believe in voodoo, stuff like that?
Well...
Your drink, monsieur.
Up here. Do you believe in voodoo?
But naturally, monsieur.
Oh, this is funny. This is really funny.
Hey, what's that?
The gums. Nothing, monsieur. Just the steel hands doing the Dutch Congo.
Oh. Well, they can't have done a hard day's work if they've got enough energy to dance at night. I think maybe I'll go down there.
Oh, no, monsieur. No.
What do you mean I must not?
I am sorry, monsieur. I just meant, well, if you are interested in voodoo conjuring, perhaps I can show you some.
You care?
Oh, I am no papalois, monsieur Vandross. I have some steel with the knuckle bone, telling fortune. And if monsieur Coates would like...
No, why not? Go ahead, Pierre.
Very well, monsieur. There. An arrow 9 times. That means unhappiness.
For whom?
I see a city far away from here. I see 2 men, both in love with the same woman.
Yeah.
Easy, Allen. Let him finish. Come on, Pierre.
One of the men is rich, powerful. The other is not. The one who is rich has his rival sent away. And in his absence, marries the girl. She knows she is making a mistake.
Oh, she does, does she? Why, you insolent!
Don't
stop! You, Colt, how dare you hit him for 2 cents, I...
Ah. All right, Mr. Bender. He did not hurt me.
Oh. Well, I haven't even started yet. You're fired.
Just a second, Colt.
Oh, Brandon. I had a hunch you weren't getting as much as you could out of the natives, that you were too soft with them. Now I know it. You're fired, too.
John, so that's why you insisted I come down here with you.
Of course.
Don't you think I know that you're still in love with him?
Okay, Coach, you asked for it. I'm...
Oh, no, you're not, Allen. I've got a gun here. Now, you stay where you are. I'm going down to the field and hut and really show them who's boss.
Allen. Oh, Allen.
It's all right, Jim. Being fired doesn't bother me. But the other things, are they true?
But it's really you, our love. Made you even sad.
Monsieur Bender, excuse me. But I think you should know. The drums, it is not the Dutch Congo. It is the Felice Beto. T. Marron is down with the dust.
What?
Who is T. Marron?
He's the most famous witch doctor on the island. John may be a swine, but he tangles with him. Listen, Muriel, you stay here with Pierre. I'm going after John.
Exactly what I've been looking for. The place where they hold their
spookaroo.
Listen, John, I never did like you much, and I shouldn't really care what happens to you, but the white-haired native that brought me in here, you know who he is.
Sure. The old coot I met on the road earlier this evening.
He happens to be Timaron, the most powerful papaloy in Haiti.
Yeah? Well, when I get finished with him, he won't show his face around this plantation again in a hurry, but...
We are ready to begin. White man, I warn you, Milanyango himself will be here. There is no telling what shape he will take, whose body he will follow.
Never mind the warnings. Go ahead.
Very well. Patty, Papa, John. Someone has the little air from the jungles of the night. Come, Ida, come. See the body, loose its soul, point its feet this way, and come, Ida, come. Come there. He has taken the body. He's coming. Quick, Patty. The war water sprinkles down the ground in front of the altar.
Hey, what is this all about? What do they think they're doing?
The bells. The bells of death. He's coming. Ida comes.
What do you hear them? Something is coming.
What do you mean?
Something.
Listen, Julius.
Can you see who or what it is?
No, not yet. He died.
The Nyango is coming. Hold on. Hold on. Down. Down.
A woman. A white woman. Walking as if she were asleep or in a trance. As soon as she gets to the altar, we'll be able to see.
Oh.
A great story. It's no.
Insisted there was no such thing as voodoo. Dared the witch doctor to invoke the god Yiranyango. And when the god did appear, he found he'd taken possession of the body of his wife. Very unusual. But not any more annoying than when a simple thing like a mean, sulky, gloomy disposition takes possession of us. Oftentimes, irregularity is entirely to blame. So the sensible thing to do is get right after it with Carter's little liberty. Now, don't let the gloom of irregularity hold you back, keep you from enjoying life and getting ahead in the world. Wake up the flow of one of your most vital digestive juices with Carter's little liver. Let them help you to feel up and at and bubbling with enthusiasm and alive with the glorious feeling that goes with regularity. Just give Carter's little liver pill to trial. And I think you'll agree that Carter's little liver pills can really be the best friend to your sunny disposition. All right. Do you still think voodoo is all nonsense?
Oh,
you're not so sure now. But you still want me to go on with our story. Very well. Just a moment later now. And Alan Brandon and John Coates are still sitting in the subterranean temple, transfixed to the corner.
Muriel. But we left her up at the house. It can't be.
But it is. She's in some kind of a trance.
Blast that witch doctor. I'm going to.
Stop, you fool. There's anything now that can play. What
would happen to her? Wait, the we've called. See you again.
Look. Look, they're all kneeling. Bowing to her.
You're nobody. With the power we've given you, bless us, Nida. Yankapum Bab. By night and by day, through the four seasons, as the green things grow, watch over us, oh, Nida, and bless us.
Look, she's raising her hands. She's blessing them.
And now, the image, horn. Take it in your hand, leader. Breathe your spirit into it.
Look, an image. She's picking it up. Putting it to her lips. Oh, you black devil, I'll cheat you. You idiot, what have you done?
What I should have done before, killed him.
Probably killed not only him, but Muriel, too. Look.
Yeah, she's just fainted.
Let's get her out of here. Back to the house, now, quick. Inside here. Put her on the couch.
Yeah, she's still unconscious. Her pulse is pretty weak.
Pierre, some brandy, hurry.
Why did they let us go like that? Not even try and stop us. All of them just sitting there, staring.
I don't know, but I'd have been happier if
you were, monsieur. What happened to madame?
That blasted witch doctor team are on some kind of a ceremony with a goat.
The blessing of the goat without horns.
He must have hypnotized her or something like that. But he won't try any more of his voodoo tricks on her or anybody else. I killed him.
Killed him? Killed team our own.
Yeah. Yeah, hold her head, Brandwine. I'll give her some of this brandy.
Brandy. I am afraid that will not help you, sir. You do not give brandy to someone who is dead.
Dead? What are you talking about?
Her heart is still beating, yes. But she is not really alive. You see, her soul left her body when Timaron called to her. When you killed him, it could not find its way back. It is out there. So, now, wandering around, lost in the night.
Why, you...
Stop it, John. Haven't you done enough harm already?
Well, we've got to get a doctor for her. Right away.
Yes, monsieur. For if her soul does not find its way back soon, it will never come back. But there is no white doctor that can help her.
Will you shut up? Where's the nearest one, Alan?
Dr. Grosskin, about 9 miles up the road. I'll show you the way.
All right, well, come on. You stay here and watch up here. And if anything happens to her...
Yes, monsieur. I will stay.
Are you coming, John? Hurry up.
Yes, all right. This soul is gone, wandering around somewhere in the night. She's fainted, that's all. Maybe it's a fever and she's out of her head. Well, which way?
Shortest way is that way there.
You mean through the jungle? When it's dark... We won't be able to see it.
Listen, Colt. You may not know it, you may not care, but Muriel's wife is in danger. I'm not sure a doctor can help her, but I'm going to get one if I have to crawl on my hands and knees. Alice.
Wait.
I don't know. Can't be much further.
Yeah. That's what you've been saying for the last hour. We're lost. That's what we are. Lost somewhere here in the jungle. Listen.
Drunk.
Yeah. And I don't care what you do. But I've had enough of this. I'm going that way.
Oh, no, wait. Come here. Don't you realize that...
Alan, look. Huts. And a fire. We're out of the jungle. Safe. It's a village.
No, Coat. Not a village. The village. The native quarter of the plantation.
Huh? What do you mean?
I mean, we've been walking in a circle and we're back where we started from.
Why? Why, it's impossible.
No, monsieur. It's not impossible. It is true.
Pierre. What are you doing here?
I knew this is where you would end up, so I came down here to wait for you.
It's a trick, that's what it is. You did this, the two of you.
No, monsieur. It was not us. It was he, Timaron.
But he's dead.
Yes, monsieur. He's dead. But come over here.
Timaron. Lying in his bed.
Yes, monsieur. And there, in his right hand, an egg. It is the fast catch conjure. Monsieur Coates, your life is in that egg. And as long as he holds it, you can never leave here.
Never leave?
But I've got to. I can't stand anymore. Ever since I shot him, those drums and the jungle surrounding us, waiting. Now listen, Pierre. I don't care what it costs. I don't even care about Muriel. But I gotta get away from here.
Oh, but that is very easy, monsieur. The egg. If you will take the egg from Timarron's finger, smash it, you will be able to go.
Take it? But that means that I'd have to touch him and I... Well, all right. I'll do it. Hey. He's holding it so tightly, it's almost as if... There. Ah. Here it is.
Drop it. Break it.
There. Now. Now, can I go?
In just a moment, monsieur.
But you said that
yes, monsieur. But I would not advise you to move at just this moment. Turn around. Slowly.
A snake. Bushman. Deadliest snake there is.
Not just a bushman. It is Dambala. Look well at its face, O Dambala. Look well so you will know it again.
That's for you, Dambala. I've had enough of this. Now I'm getting out of here and I'm taking Muriel with me. Start, Walker, both of you. Back to the house. All right. Now you stop right there. Now you listen. I'm going to get the car. Back it up here. You're going into the house, and you're going to bring Muriel out here.
Coach, she shouldn't be moved now.
Now you do as I say.
Perhaps we had better come with you then.
I can... All right. Yeah, just a second.
Yes, monsieur.
I'm asking you this as a friend. Isn't there anything that can be done? Any way she can be saved? You see, I love her.
I know, monsieur. But you know what is written. An eye for an eye. A tooth for a tooth. A life for a life.
You mean Timarron, but she didn't have anything to do with that.
No, monsieur. That is why I think she will recall it.
Now that what has to be done has been done. Muriel, darling, are you all right?
But, yes, Alan, I just feel terribly tired and weak. Is it... What happened?
You don't remember?
Well, the last thing I remember was John going down to the native quarter and you going after him. Where is John?
He's outside getting the car. You should never have brought you down here with him. He's going to take you away.
Away? Oh, Alan, no.
After all, he is your husband.
I don't care. I hate him. I hate him.
Madame was not alone in hating him. And, well, I do not think she would worry about him anymore.
What do you mean?
Somehow, I have the feeling that...
Hey there, Muriel. We'll go. Come on, Pierre. There's his car, but where is he? There he is.
Yes, monsieur.
John, what happened? What... Good Lord, he's dead.
Yes, monsieur.
What killed him?
Look there, monsieur. Crawling back into the jungle.
A bushman. The same one that... It can't be the same one he shot at.
Perhaps it is the mate of the one he shot.
Wait. There's only one way the snake could have been. If it was in the car... How could it get him? Yeah. You did it.
I? No, monsieur. The egg in Timarron's hand. The egg with his life in it. Have you forgotten that he broke that himself?
Now, do you believe in voodoo? You don't? Oh, now. Come here. Come here, a little closer. I'll whisper something in your ear. Neither do I.
And let me whisper this in your ear, folks. There are just 15 shopping days until Christmas, full of rush, hurry, and crowd. About all you can do is face things armed with a good disposition. So don't let irregularity get you down. Get after that logy, cross, irritable feeling with Carter's Little Liver Pills. Let them wake up the flow of one of your most important digestive juices and help turn those 15 shopping days into 15 topping days, full of the glorious, glad-to-be-alive feeling that goes with regularity. Remember the name, Carter's Little Liver Pills. Yes, and remember this, too. Christmas comes but once a year, but year-round, Carter's Little Liver Pills can be the best friend to your sunny disposition.
Well, this is Raymond Jehost again, getting ready to close that squeaking door to the inner sanctum until the same time next week. And don't forget, there's safety in numbers, so be sure to have all your friends listen with you. Remember, all names of characters used on the Inner Sanctum Mystery broadcast are entirely fictitious. Now, if you should happen to get into an argument with anyone about whether the dead come back from the grave, about goats without horns, black magic, and conjuring, whatnot, remember the old saying, voodoo unto others, you would have them voodoo to you. Have you read this month's Inner Sanctum Mystery novel, Trial by Fury, by Craig Rice? It's on sale at your favorite bookstore. Good night. Sweet dreams.
Listeners, be on guard. Don't let it sneak up on you like a thief in the night. What is it? Listen to this report from the Harris home, as Mrs. Harris says to her maid.
Hannah, I'll never give another party. I'm going straight to bed.
Oh, before dinner, ma'am.
I'm exhausted. All those chatting, noisy women depressed me so.
I wouldn't be too quick to blame the guests, ma'am. You've been kind of edgy and cross all week. Not like yourself at all.
Oh, you're right, Hannah. I'm sorry.
Oh, I know how it is. And when I get to feeling that way, I know it's time to try Carter's Little Liver Pills.
Right. And when you don't feel good, try Carter's Little Liver Pills. They do the work of calomel, but have no calomel in them. Well, they are simple pills made of vegetable drugs. They wake up the flow of one of our most vital digestive juices. When this vital juice flows at the rate of 2 pints a day, it helps to digest our food and bring back the glorious feeling that goes with regularity. Then most folks feel like happy days are here again. But be sure you get the genuine Carter's Little Liver Pills. 25 cents at all drugstores.
This is the Blue Network of the National Broadcasting Company.